Hi, Kerry here from My Cloud Bookkeeping. I work with small businesses and entrepreneurs to help them to get their books in order so that they can make better decisions about their business on a daily basis. Today, we're going to look at inactive accounts. So perhaps when you're looking through your chart of accounts in all of the categories, you have some that you don't use, you don't really know why they're there, perhaps they meant something in the past. So what we're going to do today is make them inactive, remove them, so when you choose to categorize your transactions, they're no longer an option. So to illustrate this, we're going to have a quick look at our income statement, the profit and loss. So we'll pop here to reports, we'll run our profit and loss report, and we'll scroll down and we can see we have some expenses here in legal and some expenses in legal and professional fees. So something's kind of gone wrong here. It doesn't look right that we'd have these two things separate. So we're going to decide that we just want legal and professional, and we no longer want to have this account here legal. So let's pop in and see what's in it. We have an expense to city lawyers. So we'll open up this expense. We're going to change it to legal and professional fees because we don't want to be having things posted to legal. And obviously we don't want to inactivate something that has transactions in it. Now, I believe you'd get a warning and probably be unable to do it, but please don't inactivate an account that has anything in it. Okay, so now we can see the entire amount is in legal and professional fees. And we want to make sure that nobody makes that mistake again. So we're going to go and we're going to make legal inactive. So we'll pop back here into our chart of accounts. And we can see we have legal and legal and professional fees. I've found these by doing the filter, by the way, just in case you're wondering. So if I don't have that filter, everything's there. Then I just filter by name and I can see them both. So what I'm going to do with this one here is I'm going to make it inactive. And yes, I'm sure I want to make it inactive. So now let's have a look and see what happens next time we get an expense from the lawyers. We pop up here to expense. And city lawyers, don't you love it when it's the sample company and you can make whatever you want? And it automatically populates with legal and professional fees. And that word legal, it's just no longer an option because the account is inactive. Now, if for any reason you wanted to be able to see which ones are inactive and which ones are active, we can scroll down here. Where are we? This time I'm doing the scroll on purpose. So it doesn't show up at all. Legal and professional does. But if you pop up to the top here and you select include inactive, then when we scroll down, we'll be able to see here, and it says that it's deleted. And we do have the option to make this account active if for any reason we decide we'd like to use it again. Now, another option would have been to merge these two accounts so that everything in legal got merged into legal and professional fees. And that would be a good idea if you're doing some sort of a big cleanup where you've kind of got stuff all over the place, but you're consolidating your income statement so that it makes more sense for you. Merging the accounts might make more sense. And there's a link to a video to show you how to go about that.
I hope that was helpful. Be sure to have a look through your income statement, your profit and loss on a regular basis. Make sure it makes sense to you. Are the categories you're using helping you to manage your business? Or are there things there that don't make sense or that you'd like to see broken down into more detail? Make sure that your reports are working for you, not just for the end of the year or your sales tax filings, and that way you'll be able to be more successful in your business every day. Now, if this video was helpful, click like, subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you again soon. Cheers.